Hello everyone, I am Niyas Sani. Today we will learn about the t-test and we will see how we can analyze the data with the help of the t-test. Before starting the t-test, we have to understand the basics of the t-test. We will understand the terminology which will be used in the t-test. The population. The population includes all of the elements from that data set. The sample. The sample is one or more observation drawn from the population. If we draw some data from the population, that will call the sample. The parameter is the measurable characteristics such as mean or standard deviation from the population. And the statistic is a measurable characteristic of the sample. The mean of the population is generally denoted by the mu, and the mean of the sample is denoted by x bar. Standard deviation. The standard deviation shows that observations are how much far from the mean value. If the standard deviations are great, then the observation will be great far from the mean value. The standard deviation for the population is denoted by sigma, and the standard deviation for the sample is denoted by the s. You can see the formula for calculating the standard deviation. For the population, the standard deviation is sigma equal to under root xi minus mu whole square upon n, while the standard deviation for the sample is s equal to under root xi minus x bar whole square upon n minus 1. Okay, the variation is the square terms of the standard deviation. So for the population, the variance is the sigma square, and the variance for the sample is s square. Hypothesis testing. In the hypothesis testing, we test a assumption regarding a population parameter. The methodology employed by the analyst depends on the nature of the data, like the data is paired or unpaired, the data is dependent or independent, or data have any correlation. And the second reason is the reason for the analysis. Why we want to perform the analysis of the hypothesis testing. Okay, so there are the two types of the hypothesis: null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. The null hypothesis saying that there is no difference between the certain characteristics of the population, and the alternative hypothesis is the vice versa of the null hypothesis. T-test. The t-test is any statistical hypothesis test in which the test statistics follow a student's t-distribution under the null hypothesis, right? So when we want to perform the t-test, first we have to we should know first what is the null hypothesis. The t-test can be used to determine if two sets of the data are significantly different from each other, and is most commonly it is applied when the test statistic would follow a normal distribution. So this is the first condition to perform the t-test: the data should be the normally distributed. Okay, now we see what is the confidence interval. The confidence interval provides a range of values for the mean response associated with a specific predictor, right? If we suppose that we are saying that there is the 95% of the confidence interval, it means that On a normal curve, 95% of the intervals would include the parameter, right? The level of significance. The level of significance generally denoted by the alpha. It is the measure of the strength of the evidence that must be present in your sample before you will reject the null hypothesis. So it is important. While you want to reject the null hypothesis, you will reject it at a certain level of the significance. The significance level is the probability of rejecting the null hypothesis when it is 2. For example, a significance level of 0.05 indicates a 5% risk of concluding that a difference exists when there is no actual difference. Okay, there is no actual difference.